Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome to another Tutorial Thursdays. We're going to talk about something that I've actually been holding off for quite a while. I don't know why, but it's been highly requested. So here it is. I just set up a green screen in my living room, and we're going to talk a little bit about that experience and some keying tips on tomorrow's video. Definitely don't want to miss that. But for now, we're actually diving into the tutorial part, the post side, and we're going to look at a few techniques and a few effects within After Effects, so completely stock, that can help you in pretty much any keying scenario. So I'm gonna try to run through it and I'm gonna try to keep it short, but there's definitely gonna be a lot of info packed into this one that can hopefully help you in your worst nightmare green screen situation. So over here, I pretty much step into the green screen and I'm looking really distraught here by whatever is in front of me. So not sure what we're gonna be adding into this, but let's focus on getting rid of the screen and the living room for now. So the first step that you want to do is get rid of the excess. So a garbage mat, I'm sure you've seen this done before. You just select the pen tool up here, and we're just going to pretty much select around our subject. Notice how I'm also getting rid of this shadow over here and a little bit of that hot spot. And by the way, guys, I did a full tutorial on how to properly light a green screen. This is not how you do it. What you're seeing right now is not a perfectly lit green screen. I just really wanted a challenge for ourselves so that we can actually go through a few techniques here. Okay, so we have a garbage mat. Sometimes you can be a little bit closer. You can make this a little bit more redefined. But since I know that I am stepping into the green screen, I don't want to actually cut off any parts. So you can see that I might have to do some adjusting here for my my top part of the bun. People have been telling me to cut it. Maybe it's time to cut it because it's making me do more post work. But something that you might want to do is, you can see how I'm extending a little bit of these points, because we can actually hit M on our keyboard and click on the stopwatch for the mask path. And this way it creates a keyframe and we can actually animate this mask so that we're closing it in. But you can see that there's a little bit of arm movement. So you want to be mindful of that, but we can definitely lose all of this side. So we can maybe bring this in a little bit so that we're not, you know, working with so much information and we're just focusing with what's around our subject. So the next step is adding Keylight. So I'm going to go under my effects and presets. And by the way, before I go any further, I'm using After Effects CC 2019. I believe that most of the features, if not all of the effects that I'm using today, come with any other CC version and maybe even some prior versions, but it's definitely worth upgrading, so definitely keep that in mind. And if you do, I really would appreciate it if you use the link in the description. So let's type in Keylight and let's add that to our footage. So the first step is selecting the screen color. So I'm gonna select this pick whip, and I don't wanna select something that's near the edge or a hotspot or the shadows. I kinda wanna select a color that represents my green screen. So sort of an average of what I have in my background here. So I'm gonna select this green right here. And you can see that already it's doing a pretty solid job. Of course, this looks horrible, but we got rid of the green, and that's a good first step. Before we go any further, I wanna actually change from final result to screen map. The reason I'm doing this is because this is going to give us a much clearer view of what we're actually doing and how we're affecting the colors, the pixels, and the alpha information in our scene. All it is showing us what is opaque and what is transparent. So white is fully opaque and black is fully transparent. The gray is anything in between that we usually want to eliminate. Sometimes you can have some gray around the edge and around hair, or maybe some elements that have a little bit of motion blur, and that's okay. But for the most part, we want to get rid of all of this. We want to make sure that this is completely white and that all of this surrounding our subject is completely black. So there's a few settings right inside of Keylight that you can adjust to make sure that you're getting a good key. So I'm going to expand screen map, and the first two that we're going to focus on is clip black and clip white. And I'm just going to increase the clip black until I see that most of this is gone. I'm gonna do the same thing for clip white, but I'm just gonna go backwards. And there we go. This is pretty nice. We can see that most of the problematic parts of our green screen are outside of our garbage mask, so that's really good. Now, sometimes you might get some dead pixels or just some random noise and some holes into your subject, or maybe even some opaque parts that are showing up in your green screen. This is where you can kind of mess around with D-spot black and D-spot white, but I wouldn't go too far with these because it gets pretty clumpy and pretty nasty real quick. So right now in my case, fortunately, I don't have any of that, but you can mess around with this a little bit. But I'm also going to show you other ways later on in this tutorial on how to refine the edges and how to refine any possible spots or anything that you have on your subject. So let's take a look at the intermediate result. It's looking pretty clean, pretty clean. Now, it's not perfect yet, but as a first step, this is looking pretty nice, especially considering how I am out of focus. Did not really plan on doing that, but you know. And by the way, there's actually a lot of steps that you want to make sure that you're taking when shooting your green screen footage. So we're gonna take a look at that tomorrow. This is just a bad example that we're using, but we're gonna make this work. But keep in mind that there's a few tips that you definitely want to make sure to do when you're shooting your footage in order to have success in post. Now, before moving on to the other effects, I just want to click through here and make sure that I don't have anything weird going on, especially around the hair or any part that's moving really fast. You just want to click through your sequence and your timeline, and you want to make sure that you know you're getting a pretty clean key all around. Now, of course, there's some issues here which we're going to fix right now. To clean up these edges and this key, we're going to use a key cleaner. So here it is. I'm going to drag it into my footage. It's going to take a little bit to load. And there we go. So we're not really paying too much attention to the green hue of it. We're going to take care of that later. But for right now, we want to make sure that the edges are cleaned up, they're not as harsh, and that they can blend into whatever composition we're adding behind it. So let's take a look before and after. Now, it's not perfect. It's essentially just blurring out and softening the edges a little bit, but we can definitely make some adjustments. So we can reduce the chatter. And just by selecting that box, it's going to smooth out any moving parts around our edge. I don't know if you notice this in your keys or in other people's keys, but sometimes there tends to be a lot of fuzziness moving around, especially on the edges. So reduce chatter, checking this box, will definitely help a lot with that. Now, you can mess around with the alpha contrast, so we can just crank this way up just to show you what it does. So in our scenario, maybe we want to do like something like 15%. That's looking pretty good. We can also decrease the strength if we think that it's you know, hurting our footage a little bit too much, but I'm gonna keep it pretty high up, especially considering that our shot is a little bit out of focus. So this is looking pretty good. Just wanna look around the creases of my shirt, making sure that everything is good. Everything is looking nice as far as the edge. Now, we're still getting that greenish hue around me, so we're gonna fix that with the next effect. So under effects and presets, I'm gonna look for advanced spill suppressor. There it is. I'm gonna double click on that. That's just gonna add it to our footage. And take a look at what that does. Pretty great considering the issues that we were having. So I'm gonna uncheck it. You can see that really nasty green spill making its way into the edges. And if I activate the advanced spill suppressor, pretty amazing. And by the way, this is a black background, but of course, if I toggle this transparency grid switch down here, you can see that we're, you know, it's transparent. Drop a background right below our keyed footage. This is a matte painting I did. And by the way, guys, if you want to learn how to make stuff like this, like all these environments and these spaces, which could be really great to tell your sci-fi story or whatever else, or even expand your world and kind of achieve a higher budget look without spending a bunch of money and just, you know, expanding your world this way, let me know, because I've been thinking about doing a matte painting workshop and it could be really interesting. But anyways, for now, let me not get carried away. I just want to match this footage as best as I can to this background. Now, this is not what this tutorial is about, so I'm gonna just really do it very quickly, and I'm just gonna show you a few very quick effects that you can add that can help you get closer to that goal. So here, I'm just gonna first start with the contrast. So I'm just gonna try to set my luminance value to something that can be a lot closer to this background. Something that helps is expanding the info box over here, this panel. And here you can see that we have a box that essentially previews us what color we're on with our cursor. And we have an RGB and alpha value information here as well. So I'm gonna go over my black t-shirt since this is the darkest color that we have in our keyed footage. And I'm gonna take a look at what these numbers up here are. And I'm gonna try to get really close to whatever values are in my darkest area of my matte painting. So you can see that we're pretty close. It just takes some fine tuning and some tweaking. And of course, sometimes it doesn't have to be exact. For example, here, I'm gonna make my subject a little bit darker because I kind of want to add a sense of atmosphere. So our foreground element has a little bit more contrast than what's in the background because things that get further away usually have a lot less contrast. So I'm not gonna spend too much time tweaking around with this. You get them an idea with that. So let's move on to the red channel. And essentially, I'm just slowly taking away colors that are not really present in the background. So you can see that this is very muted and it's kind of monochromatic, has a lot of just blue highlights, but it does have some red. So I want to make sure that I'm staying true to that. Of course, I'm doing this with complete disregard to skin tones. I'm just showing you how to do a very, very basic match. Another thing that I've kind of experimented with and that actually helps a lot is adding a tint effect. And I'm going to select a brighter color around here. And I'm going to select a darker color around here. And then I'm just going to decrease the amount of tint. I'm going to add another one once again. I'm going to just keep picking colors that are in my scene until I get a blend that is pretty nice. And then maybe darken the black here. Brighten this. So you can kind of keep playing around with this, but you kind of see where I'm going. I'm starting to introduce some colors that are in my scene, and I'm just going to keep doing that with a bunch of other effects. But the main ones that I use are curves, some tint, some hue and saturation, and sometimes I go into lumetri, which is really powerful for doing this kind of stuff. But again, I just want to get to a point where this looks somewhat acceptable. Of course, all the hardcore color correctors and everyone else is going to drill me, but I'm not trying to do that right now. I just want to get a finished result that looks somewhat okay and that can show off what a good job we did with our key. I do want to show you one more trick. I'm just going to leave it like this. It's not good at all, but I just want to move on and show you one last thing. And I'm going to create a new solid. And in here, I'm going to select a color that is closest to my highlights of my scene. And I'm going to click OK. I'm going to turn it off for now. And I'm gonna scale it up. And then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create a circular shape around this highlight over here. So something like that. And then move this shape a little bit closer here. I'm gonna turn it back on and I'm going to feather the edges out quite a bit, like a lot. Move this up a little bit and set this to screen. Now, let's say that we don't want it to affect our background like this. It's kind of losing its impact, but we do like how this light is kind of falling off onto our subject since it's making it fit a little bit more into our scene. What we can do is we can duplicate our footage with the green screen, place it above our solid that we just created, and then tell it to look at the alpha matte of our footage. So we're going to set the solid track matte to look at the alpha matte. And now you can see that it's only affecting our subject. So if I move the solid around, you can see that it's contained only within our top footage. Now this is very extreme, of course, but you can see that you can add nice little highlights here and there that can really make your footage match a lot better with the lighting of your scene. Now, of course, you're looking at an example that was shot completely blind, meaning, you know, not knowing what I was going to put behind it. So if you're shooting this, obviously spend the time to do the proper lighting on set when you're shooting it and you know, have a reference photo and just try to get it really close. So I would put maybe a light, you know, like a LED panel or a spotlight or something that can get me a little bit of an edge over here that would make sense with this highlight over here. Something maybe here for the face. And I would definitely do a much moodier lighting. So, you know, it all starts from there. But of course, these are some effects that you can add to your footage to really help in terms of compositing it into your scene. So I could ramble on and on about compositing this into the scene. That's not what this tutorial is about. I hope you learned something about keying, and hopefully it will help you in whatever situation you're in. These sets of effects have definitely helped me in my career and anytime I need to green screen anything. And definitely tune into tomorrow's video, because I'm actually going to be sharing the 10 key tips of what you need to do whenever you're shooting with a green screen. So you definitely don't want to miss out on that, because it's going to have a lot of information on what to do in order to give you the best results when you're later dealing with the footage and post. All right, guys, that is it for me for now. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed this Tutorial Thursdays, and I will see you tomorrow.